Hello and welcome to the Battle Line Podcast. This is the place where we have conversations on that collision of space between community, faith, and culture. I'm one of your hosts, Matt Satterley, and here with me is the National Director of all publications of the Salvation Army, my co-host on this podcast, all publications, everything nationally.
All just right. The ones that come out of the national office. Don't send me your mail about the other ones. They're fantastic. Those letters you can send me.
My co-host on this podcast and my co-host in life, Major Jamie Satterley. Major Jamie, how are you doing this wonderful fall day?
I'm doing pretty good. It's a good day.
All right. We also have with us, as always, our other co-host, the producer, the one who makes this whole thing run. I think I said last episode I was going to look up your job title before we start. I didn't do it. It's the National Director of Multimedia Stuff, Elizabeth. Elizabeth, how are you doing today?
I am so super wonderful, and I dig the fun title you give me every episode. It's marvelous.
National Director of Multimedia. We're just going to call it that.
I dig there it.
There you go. We'll just change it every week. Sign this new job description. It's fine.
If HR is listening, I apologize.
All right. So we have a really exciting episode today. Maybe you've heard of SA Gaming. Gaming is a billion-dollar industry complete with its own subculture and lingo. And this digital world is kind of a new open-air opportunity for us, right, in the Salvation Army. Today, we're going to be talking with Zane Kohler from the Central Territory about this new ministry that they've kicked off called SA Gaming.
Oh man, Zane, we're great. It's great to have you. Thanks. Let's jump right in. First question. Tell us about yourself. Where are you from? How long you've been working for the Salvation Army? What do you do for the Salvation Army?
Yeah, I joined the Central Youth Territorial. Central Territorial Youth Department in October of 2014. I graduated from Columbia College Chicago in May of 2014. With a degree in arts, entertainment, media management, expecting to be working in the music industry. Wasn't sure how I was going to get in there. Preferably wanted to get into the Christian side of the industry. Had no leads when graduating. One of the youth leaders from the Metropolitan Division reached out to me to be a leader for a summer-long ministry program called Band Survivors. I was like, why not? I got nothing else going on in my life. Did that. Had no plans coming out of that ministry for the fall. The current PYS at the time reached out to me just to give me some practice for interviewing with no intention of actually giving me a job. Just wanted to give me the experience. Did the interview. I had no desire to actually work for the Salvation Army at all. I've been part of the Salvation Army my whole life, but never really thought that I'd work for them or work for the organization. And so I guess I did really well. I got the job. I'm here today. I started in October 2014, like I said, and I got the role of Youth Communications and Event Support Specialist, which I feel like is very long, but now it's even longer. Where my job just got changed on May 31st, actually, of 2021. And it's now SA Gaming Ministry Director and Youth Communications and Event Support Specialist. So I believe I have the longest title at Central's THQ. So that's that. But yeah, so it's a like I said, I've been a part of the Salvation Army my whole life. I played in our chorus brass band. I was part of the Chicago staff band for several years. And then I switched over to our other territorial music group, the Sing Company at the time. And now kind of moved over and been doing some more production stuff with the Salvation Army and in our department. And then brought that to SA Gaming. Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at. I'm based out of Chicago in the suburbs, so it's a good time right now, and I'm still working for the Salvation Army and expect to be here this long, to be honest, but I'm thankful for right now for what my job has led to. So it's been a journey, but I'm excited.
That's excellent. So we just heard this in your title, but tell us a little bit about what SA Gaming is
Like, what was the vision behind it? How did it get started?
Yeah, so SA Gaming did not start off as SA Gaming. First off, if you want, we can go way back. I've had a passion for video games for a long time. And as I like got more serious in gaming and also wanted to include my faith in my walk with Christ with that, I was trying to figure out what's the best way or how can we make this happen. And there was another, I have a friend of mine named Julio, where he has a passion for gaming. We talked for years about like, how can we make this happen? He pitched the idea to our division, for like a gaming weekend, like to try to start something. And it just never went anywhere from there. So it was just kind of like, okay, whatever. So then, we kind of did like some small testing things where, I think it was at a summer camp or something where we just threw Mario Kart up on a projector during free time for an event. And kids loved it. It was like, okay, there is a possibility with this. But then again, it went nowhere. So it was like, all right, well, we'll just carry on with life. And then towards the end of 2019, myself and another coworker, we kept talking about this gaming ministry, like, could it be a thing? What can happen with it? So we kind of sat on it. We pitched the idea to our TYS, and he just said, yeah, just give me some more information about it. So we kind of did that. We had a young adult conference coming up called Regeneration, as well as a youth leader event coming up. So we had to kind of put our focus into that. That all happened, went great. I think at this point, COVID had made its way to the U.S. I'm not sure the timeline of what COVID was at that point. but as soon as Regen was over, my wife and I, we went on a cruise. It was my first cruise, and I was nervous as can be. Not about the COVID, more about the ocean. And I was like, if I focus on the gaming ministry stuff, I feel like I can get through this cruise. I decided to put that on hold though to make sure that it was my wife had a good time and I didn't spoil it for her and that I can try to enjoy that. But then this is kind of where it all comes around. We got back home, I think it was March 12th, came into the office on March 13th, which I think was a Monday. And that was kind of like the last day that the world was kind of open. And because we knew that THQ was probably going to be closed the next day. I had high hopes that it was going to. And we went to Captain Mike Hansen, who was our TYS here in Central Territory, and said, what do you think about this? Can we start this? We had big post-it notes of just information on what the ministry could be, what we would need to do, how it can be done and everything. We pitched it. They're like, yeah, let's do it. This might be like the perfect time for it. I was like, all right, cool. We're going to go home. That night, I created our Discord server, created March 13th. I've had kids go scroll all the way back through the chat to make sure that my date was correct. They still can't believe that I can remember that, but it's when you've had a passion so long, it's like you kind of remember that start date. So yeah, so we started March 13th, created that as just a initial plan, really, just for the Central Territory, just to see what we could do with it. And at that time, it was called CYN Esports, yep. And it was kind of that for about, I think, so March 13th, and we became SA Gaming that following October. So SA Gaming launched on October 16th of 2020. So that's kind of how SA Gaming started. We realized that this ministry could be way bigger than Central Territory. And we're like, all right, we're just going to go for it. And we changed the name and everything. I believe it was in September, quote unquote, officially. And then we just launched it in October. And we're here now after we had our year anniversary this past October, which is amazing. I'm super proud of the community and the work that all my guys have done to help make SA Gaming what it is. I don't take any credit for it at all. It's all God's work, and it's I'm just providing the space for everyone, and it's the kids and the adults in there is what makes SA Gaming what it is. So I have nothing but thanks and applause for them for making SA Gaming what it is today.
That's great. Man, okay, three takes real quick there, Zane. Number one, it was CYN Games, right? CYN Gaming. And it's amazing that you guys moved so quickly. Like you saw this, you know, coronavirus shutdown, and you guys moved incredibly quick to set this whole thing up, and it's still running. And I think the spiciest take is that you just kind of skipped over this, but you, my man, were on a cruise ship as the coronavirus was rolling into town. Jeez.
Yeah, we were, I think we were one of the very last cruise ships to actually come back in. So it was like, we talked about it the whole time. I got to know a lot of the entertainment people on staff. I didn't like looking at the water. This kind of plays into a lot of the stuff that we do in SA Gaming now. I did every trivia night or time on the cruise. I got to know the person that hosted that every time. I finally won a trophy. It felt great. We talked about the COVID and everything, or coronavirus. And so it was just like, COVID was thankfully a blessing for this ministry. I know
for
that
sure.
Lot happens in 2020 and 2021, and still is happening. But this is a positive thing that blossomed out of this crazy past few years, thankfully.
Zane, some people, when they hear gaming, they get immediately nervous, right? Like hackles go up because they just, you know, they think when they think video game, they think this is the deterioration of, you know, the human brain of society. Like they think, I don't want my kids, when they think SA Gaming, they think, man, are they all just shooting? You know, is this all doom and gloom? Doom, see what I did there? Old school game, shooting up, that kind of stuff. So can you take a moment? Can you explain to people who are a little nervous right now about hearing SA Gaming? Can you explain to them what it really kind of is? And then can you even maybe say a few things about what is it not?
For sure. Yeah, so right away when someone hears video games, if they're against it, all the thing about it mushes your brain, or everything is violence, that right away that's not true. A ton of games that are out there are not violent at all. Like one of the biggest ones you can have, like Animal Crossing. It's a game that you play on Nintendo Switch. It's all about just building a friendly village, you know, and that's a big sure. game. But yeah, violence is it's just a part, a small part of the overall gaming industry and games that are out there. But for us, the ministry of SA Gaming isn't about the games. It's about the community and bringing the gospel to the gamer. The games is just the hook point. It's like that's where the people are. And the cool thing is we didn't have to create a whole new space or anything for us to reach the people that were out there during the time. COVID made almost everything virtual. We knew that the kids were already there. The platform already existed. We just had to create a virtual room or space for that to happen. And we invited them to it. And it's all about community. It's, like I said, it's not about the games. It's about the relationships that we build, discipleship happening. I can go super deep into our Discord server and everything that we offer. Like we have weekly devos that we put out. We have prayer request channels. We have answered prayers. Every division in the Salvation Army for at least North America has a divisional chat that I put in there, that where people can go in there and just talk about what That's they incredible. Have there. And it's, like I said, the biggest thing is the community. That's what we are. It's a big support system. We have kids, or youth, I don't want to say kids, but we just people in general where they're sharing things that they're struggling with. And I feel like in my experience with youth in today's age, it's hard to really get people to fully say what they're struggling with or to just express themselves without having the fear of being judged or being embarrassed or anything like that. So we have kids that are opening up about struggling with like pornography or their walk with Christ and things of whatever it is. And it also goes down to something as simple as, my dog is sick. Can you please pray for me or pray for the dog? And I was That's like, good. Yeah, for sure. You know, and they see people will react to those. That just simply means we're praying for you. And they know that they've got a community of over almost 800 members from around the world that are there to support them. So yeah, it's all about community. It's not about the video games.
For sure. Yeah. A couple of things that I love. I love this whole SA gaming thing. One, this is what the Salvation Army is all about. This is how Open Airs got started, right? We said we have a gospel message. Where are the people? They're out in the streets. Okay, let's go there. Well, now 2020, 2021, where are the people? They're video gaming. Millions and millions of people play video games around the world. So this is what the Salvation Army does. We got a gospel message. Where are the people? They're gaming. Let's go over there. And one of the things that I appreciate as a parent is that this provides a safe place for kids to go and play video games. Again, kids are out there. They're playing games. And we can't always control. This freaks me out as a parent, just like how people, you know, can talk to my kid or drop things in the chat. You know, or whatever. And I can't, you know, there's no filters really all the time. But by having this kind of platform provides a safe place where I don't have to worry about what my child is seeing while they're playing video games. You know, I know that it's a safe space for them to be. And so I love that. Another interesting thing that I just learned from a friend of mine is that you can get scholarships to college for gaming, which is wild to me.
I actually had this discussion with a friend 2 days ago where the parent was saying their kid only wants to just play video games. And he's like, there's no future in that. And I was like, that's actually very wrong. I can name you 30 career paths right now that video games leads into. And so it's the possibilities of this video games in general is crazy.
Yeah. And so that's what, you know, I say too, like, okay, well, you know, we got to kind of change the way our minds think about gaming. You know, we got academic scholarships, football scholarships, you know, athletic scholarships. Now we got gaming scholarships. And you're right. As this progresses, the world is just opening up in possibilities of what this looks like for career paths. But they did when I was a kid, that was the thing. You can't, there's no future in video games. It just rots your brain. Go outside and play. but you're right. There's such an opportunity there, but also just the community aspect. I think that's probably one of the reasons, if I had to guess, why this was so successful, or has been as successful as it's been, is because especially during a pandemic, when we're so cut off from each other, to have a community, you know, it's what we were built for. We're hardwired for community. And so to be able to offer that to young people through this avenue of gaming, I think is a incredible opportunity for us. Zane, if you are like dreaming about the future of SA gaming, what's kind of your hope for it? Where would you like to see it end up?
First off, the thing that I will always keep in the front of my mind with this ministry of where I want it to go, and I'm always working on it. I never wanted to go away is that it's a, like you said earlier, and I forgot to mention, so I'm sorry. It's a safe space for everyone and anyone. Everyone has a different background, a different story, different life struggles. Doesn't matter if you believe in Christ or not. if you're part of the Salvation Army or not. You may not. We have members that have no idea what the Salvation Army even is, and they're a part of our community and they love it. So that's something that as SA Gaming grows, I never want that to go away. That's always at the forefront of what we're doing. It's open to everyone. Everyone is accepted. There's no bullying of any nature, no harassment. I won't stand for that. And I have a team in place and guidelines set in place that help me enforce all that, so that anytime someone joins, they can always feel that it's a safe space, a positive space for the SA Gaming community. The gaming industry is a very toxic and dark place, and having the ability to have a safe and Christian environment for people to come to, they're loving it. It's surprised me actually with how much that the positivity that I've gotten back from that, which is amazing. So that's the first thing I'll say. For the future, is to continue being accepting and open for anyone to join. So with that now, we're in a spot now to where in the world, COVID's kind of, it's still there, but things are starting to open up and people are figuring out ways to still start doing events or whatever in a socially distanced and safe ways. So now that things are opening up, kids and the youth and even adults as well are going back to more their new norm for whatever that is. And now the challenge is, okay, so the online presence isn't because we're not home 24/7 now. So now how do we keep this ministry going and growing? And the answer right now that I have for that is taking it from a virtual side of things to a more localized mission, to where whether that's starting something at a core or a community center, a craft center, or a division starting up their own monthly game stream or something online, whether it's streaming to YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, or TikTok. So that's kind of like right now the future of taking SA Gaming from virtual to a localized in-person events. That's kind of where I'm seeing right now and trying to push for. And everyone now, if they're playing video games, they're wanting to stream. They're wanting to see themselves on a phone or a tablet or computer. And if we have one of our youth that's being featured, they're probably going to want to tell their friends about it. And that's more exposure for SA Gaming, and then also the gospel getting out to someone else. And now what I say about the gospel, we're not always like throwing Bible scripture or things like that down someone's throat. Sorry if that's harsh or anything, but it's a lot of what SA Gaming is how we treat everyone that's in the community, and we treat them how Christ would. And sometimes that's all that those people might take from it. We can talk about the Bible and everything, and if they have no idea who Christ is, they may not want to listen to that. So just by the way we treat them and how we interact with them, sometimes that's all the Christ that they need, and that can also open up the door for more deeper conversations, hopefully in the future. But so that's having that ability to where a kid's going to be on the screen, and their friends can see that, and maybe their friend will be like, oh, I want to be a part of that. Now we got the hook into them. They're coming, or they join the server, or they're joining their, just come to the church on a weekly game night, or whatever that might be. That's kind of like what the future that I'm seeing right now, and hopefully bring in live gaming events and portable arenas to any church, a core, day camp, summer camp, commissionings, whatever it is, to where we can really just kind of provide a safe, positive, fun, and still competitive competitions or just gaming events to anywhere in the Salvation Army. I would love to have SA Gaming be a known identity and team within the gaming industry as a whole, as we hopefully will also enter into competitive esports leagues, hopefully this coming fall, or next fall, I should say, or hopefully sooner, you never know. So that's kind of where I'm wanting to see. It's going into live events, divisional and local ministries, and then competitive esports.
That's incredible, Zane. Like, I'm looking forward to that day when we have commissioning or Congress and you've got, you know, the this going on. But then right in the wing next door, you've got like the, you know, the mobile gaming toe behind pulled up. You know, that's just awesome. That's awesome. All right. So we have quite a few parents, grandparents, youth leaders who check out this podcast. We also have people who are international, who don't necessarily live in the United States, who listen to this podcast as well. So this is the money question right here. How can young people be a part of this? How do they join up? How do they get into this community? What can youth leaders do to be part of the ministry? How can they help you out with that? And then you have this incredible resource. And you mentioned it the other day in one of our meetings, but if a core really wants to get maybe start, you know, getting into this gaming ministry, what would you tell them? So, sorry, it's a three-pronged question. How do kids get involved? How do youth leaders get involved? And then how can a core jump into this game if they want?
For sure, yeah. The best way and the easiest way to get involved with the SA Gaming Ministry and community is to go to salvationarmygaming.com. That'll bring you to our clean, beautiful website where there's a button. If you scroll down a little bit, it says join our Discord. You click that button, it's easy as that. If you don't have Discord already, you'll have to create a profile or also download the app if you're doing it from a mobile device. And then there you have it, you're in the community, you're in our Discord server, and the world is now open to everything that we have to offer. So it's as simple as that. You go to salvationarmygaming.com, click the button that says join our Discord, and that's your way in. So that's the easiest way to join. If they're doing it at a low level, it just the core needs to provide, hey, we're doing this game night. And then just invite all your friends. It's the simplest way to do that in person.
That's awesome.
Like you said, we talked about, I think it was last week or a few weeks ago with a previous meeting. I created this simple and effective starter kit, SA Gaming starter kit that I want available. And it's all of it is just a simple package to where if you're interested in wanting to get a gaming ministry started at your core, your building, wherever it's at, here's what you need. It's simply just to provide inspiration and ideas for what your gaming ministry can look like. I will say now that the easiest way to get it started is to purchase a Nintendo Switch. They just came out with a new one this past fall, and it's the cheapest gaming system that's out there besides your phone. Actually, no, I think phones nowadays cost more than what the Nintendo Switch does. So I will stand firm and say it's probably the cheapest one, and it's portable, which is amazing. But the nice thing is, like, I don't know if the listeners, wherever you're at, if you have places that say, oh, we can't do this because we have bad internet, with the Nintendo Switch, you don't need internet to play it, which is amazing. So you can just automatically just cut off that excuse. Be like, here you go, which is amazing. So and Nintendo is all about party games and including people with that. So that's the first thing, is just having a Nintendo Switch. And from there, I have a TV setup option that you can do, and I give you the cheapest options that are available to do that setup. Or if you want to do a projector setup, there again, it's all the cheapest options while still having good quality. So that's kind of designed just to be like, hey, here's what you can have. You might find a better option or solution for your situation, or you'd be like, oh, if I have a bigger budget than what I thought, this isn't costing as much as I thought it would, I can upgrade to the next best thing that provide. If that's open for you, sorry.
If people wanted to get that from you, can they just email you directly?
Yes, right now they can email me directly at zane.kohler@usc.salvationarmy.org. It will be available as well in our Discord. I'm working right now on like a big press kit type thing to where it'll be a bigger package where if someone wants to download, here it is. Here's all the links for it. But right now, if you want that directly, you can contact me or contact the Satterleys, and they'll be able to get that out to you, as well as I'm still finalizing, make sure it's perfect for everyone. But yeah, that is totally available and an easy tool to get the ministry started.
That's so great, Zane. So our last question for today is what is it that you need from Salvation Army listeners out there? Maybe even people who aren't gamers, but still love the thought of this kind of ministry. How can they support SA Gaming?
Yeah, so this is a tricky question, but at the same time, it's very simple. We just need the support and prayers. Not for the ministry itself, but more for the gamers that we have in the community. It's a lot of people think that it's just about games and coming together to play video games, but the kids really do connect with the ministry and they need your prayers and support. For some of these kids, it saved their lives during COVID. And then some of them are just like, it's their passion for gaming. And it's, I'm starting to get emotional. I'm sorry. Some people have tried telling me that the ministry is not going to work. It's going to fail. I'm like, that's where you're wrong. It's already been successful. If the Salvation Army wanted to cut off the gaming with this ministry and say it's not working, it has, and it continues to keep working. I just want to share kind of some of these testimonies that some of the kids have shared. Hopefully, I'm sorry.
No, you're good. You're good. You're building, it's building community. And this is what we talked about our last episode, is like what the world is desperate for right now is community, being able to talk to somebody. And even if we're miles apart, thousands of miles apart, countries apart, what you're doing with SA Gaming is making it possible for people to be together in community. Like you said, it's the hook that just gets them there. And then the gospel is presented and it's a safe place and community is built. So we just want to say thank you so much, Zane, for that. Can you, as we get ready to wrap this up, Major Jamie's going to ask our last question here, but I love what you end every SA Gaming with when you say, I don't want to steal the line, but how you end every prayer. So can you give that to our listeners before Major Jamie asks this last question?
Yeah, we end every prayer with in your name we play. It's instead of in your name we pray, it's in your name we play.
That's awesome. It's good stuff. All right. So you're going to reach out to Zane if you're interested in that core thing, but we are encouraging all of our people to go to SA Gaming, SalvationArmyGaming.com. Zane, we can edit this out, but do you want to go ahead? We can put this in anywhere. Do you want to go ahead and just give a few more testimonies?
Yeah. If I could, it'd be awesome. One of our kids has something to say about what SA Gaming means to them. SA Gaming has brought me to make friends, and throughout the summer, I spent most of my time playing with or talking to my new friends. And I've even brought a couple of friends who are having a hard time to this server, and they've met people that have helped them. SA Gaming is a place where you can do you. You can have no worries of people judging you or mistreating or bullying you. And I'm so glad and grateful that I can be a part of this wonderful community. Another kid has to say, I said, gaming helped me with my kind of sad life and has brought me back into art, and I could be with friends and have fun on the Minecraft realm that with his brother, and has changed who he is and brought him to a happier life with new people to keep me company and to get back into an old thing I did, which was to make stories in paper. And I have felt like a decayed person before SA Gaming, but now I feel great with the help of God and friends. We as a server can grow and have fun with each other by playing Minecraft, Roblox, and Smash Brothers, Super Smash Brothers, and any and much more without SA Gaming. Without SA Gaming, and my first Discord friend, I would have been a way different person and still be sad. But here we are. I'm doing comedies, drawing comics, and being raised by practicing. And it makes me happy when I or the people in the server can entertain you. It makes us happy when we get positive stuff from our staff, and it makes us want to do it more. So thank you, SA Gaming, and my friends for making me who I am today. Sorry, that one was kind of all over the place.
No, these are great, Zane.
And then the last one. I have several, but this will be the last one. SA Gaming gave me things to put on my calendar and gave me a chance to communicate with other Christians who love art and gaming. It made me communicate more than usual and changed my whole life. It's a very fun and peaceful community and is overall very much enjoyable.
Incredible stuff, Zane. Thank you. Thank you again for the ministry that you're doing. Thank you for all the monitors and everybody who had a part and for letting people take a, you know, thank you to the Central Territory for being willing to try something new and just to see the incredible results that are coming out of it. So, Zane, we're praying for you. We're praying for your gamers. Man, incredible things ahead for SA Gaming. Check them out again, www.salvationarmygaming.com. Major Jamie?
Yeah, so it's time for our favorite, not our favorite question, but our kind of question that we ask every week. What is bringing you joy? Elizabeth, what's bringing you joy this week?
Okay, so I have realized that plaid is the greatest pattern of all time, and I love it.
So plaid itself, just plaid, is giving you joy.
Do you have a favorite plaid?
That is such a wonderful question.
Here's the thing. There's types?
Yeah, like different, like there's Buffalo Check.
Ooh.
You know, Matt, if you would know if you saw them, there's like the black and white one, the red and black one, the green and blue one.
Yeah, when you say there's types of plaid, I'm just thinking there's red, blue, black, green, orange, whatever.
I'm not that advanced in my plaid knowledge, but I grew up 13 years wearing plaid, so I didn't appreciate it then. But now that I have some distance, it is brilliant. I love it so much.
Yeah. Whenever I think about like quintessential plaid, this is going to show my age. I always think about that movie Clueless.
That's my dream plaid. I look for that outfit every week on the internet. I want it so bad.
That's so fun. Zane, what about you? What's bringing you joy?
Joy right now is that I had to think about this before I said to make sure we have announced publicly. My wife and I are expecting a beautiful baby.
Hey, all right.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, she's due in, I think, towards the end of May. So we're slowly planning our future with that and figuring out what that's going to look like with planning and getting the crib and stroller and all this. So this will be our first baby. I'm praying for a healthy pregnancy for both my wife and our baby that's coming. And also, I'm a performer. I perform with a drum line. We just performed at the United Center yesterday for United Airlines. It was amazing.
And that's awesome.
We will be on TV tomorrow for this group. And it was kind of always been a dream of mine to perform at the United Center. So I got to check that off my list yesterday. And so that's kind of bringing me joy And the physical aspect and the mentality is kind of a nice break from all the work that I've been doing for SA Gaming and just things outside of what I'm doing here at the Army. So that's 3 weeks right now. My family and our coming baby, and then all the drumming and performance stuff that I'm doing.
Zane and his wife got a green mushroom from Mario and got a new life. That's awesome.
Yes.
I hope that I do hope that the entire family or everybody has been notified, because if somebody finds out on here, man, you are in trouble.
I have to think about it. We announced it. Yeah, we're good. We're good.
For me, I think I'm going to have to go with there are two psalms that I've been reading a lot lately, and I'm not trying to Jesus juke anybody. I'm not trying to be like, haha, look at me, I picked a psalm, huh? But Psalm 91, Psalm 112, those have just come in clutch for me over the last like day or two. Psalm 91, Psalm 112. So your homework assignment is go read those as soon as we finish, after you go to SavageArmyGaming.com and join the Discord server. Major Jamie, finish us up. What is bringing you joy?
Yeah, so I think what's bringing me joy this week is just the opportunity. We've been talking a lot about community. Last night, we're recording this on a Friday, so we always have activities at the core on Thursday. And things are kind of, now that they're opening back up, we're able to gather again. I'm able to play in the band, you know, singing the songsters. After youth activities are over, all the kids come into the little gym area and play Foursquare, which is always a chaotic good time. But it's just a blessing, I think, to be able to be back in community again, and to be able to experience fellowship as a core family. So I really enjoy that Thursday nights and getting to be with people again.
Zane, thank you so much for what you're doing with Salvation Army Gaming. Again, if you want to reach out to Zane, you hit him up first. Go through the website, SalvationArmyGaming.com. But he can be reached at Zane.Kohler, K-O-E-H-L-E-R, at usc.salvationarmy.org. That's going to end this episode of the Battle Line Podcast. Be sure to subscribe to the Battle Line wherever you listen to podcasts, and go check out the Peer website at peermag.org, and follow Peer on the socials at peer.magazine. Lastly, we always hype our sister podcast, The Fight for Good. Major Jamie, what's coming up on The Fight for Good?
The next episode, we're going to be talking about Angel Tree. How that got started. We're actually with the kind of creator, founder of the Angel Tree, Lieutenant Colonel Shirley White. So that's coming up. And then we'll also be doing an episode soon about the national Christmas theme, Hope Marches On, and how you can partner with the Salvation Army this Christmas.
Thank you much. Until next time, this has been the Battle Line Podcast. Bye.